Between his own kids at home and those he's teaching, Matt Fabry's bubble is quite big.
My bubble has hundreds of people in it.
Fabry isn't saying teachers should be the first in line to get the COVID-19 vaccine, but he thinks they should be among the next.
We have to prioritize. If we're going to make schools and daycares a priority, then we have to make those who work in schools and daycares a priority.
It's an argument made by many groups representing educators and childcare workers in Canada and the U.S. They highlight that a vaccine for children won't be ready anytime soon, and that's not the only thing they're worried about.
We are calling on government to make sure that teachers are part of that those first rounds of vaccines after the vulnerable populations and the healthcare workers. But we are in buildings that don't have good ventilation. We have classrooms that students cannot physically distance because of the size of the room and the number of students that are in that room.
This infectious disease physician says the second group to receive the vaccine will likely include essential workers.
So that could be, you know, individuals who work in grocery stores or, you know, in pharmacies and places like that. But, you know, it is, of course, open to some interpretation.
Teachers technically do not fall into that group, but they do have a strong case.
I think that there are a lot of reasons why it would be important to prioritize, you know, people who support our education system, those who help to provide childcare as well in that next tier of rollout, because of that really essential service that they do play in society.
Provincial health officials in charge of vaccine distribution are staying tight-lipped on whether teachers will be among the second group to get vaccinated. They're saying that decision will be made based on the latest medical advice and scientific evidence. No word yet on when that call will happen. Deanna Sumanac-Johnson, CBC News, Toronto.